那导师就说了,
you know, when I was a young man your age, that time, always I was chasing after happiness.
那他说, 当我年轻的时候, 像你这个年纪的时候呢, 我一直追求着快乐。
But no matter how fast I ran after happiness, always it was ahead of me. I could never reach it.
但是无论我都跑多么的快呢, 那快乐总是跑在我前面, 无法追上。
Then I met my teacher, and then my life changed.
那后来我遇到我的老师，那我的生命就开始转变了。
As part of my training, as part of my practice, always I've been running since that time away from happiness.
那由那时候开始，打从那时候开始呢，我的训练，他给我的训练就是跑离开快乐。
But the problem is, no matter how fast I run, always it is catching up to me.
可是呢，问题是，无论我跑多么快呢，都是给快乐追赶上来了。So
some years ago, there was a famous book that circulated around. Many people were fascinated by it, called The Secret. It's supposed to be a secret to becoming happy.
然后几年前呢，有一本书挺流畅的。 那书名叫做《秘密》, 可能是关于开心的秘密, 寻找开心的秘密, 很多人都在看。
So actually the book Secret was about getting what you want.
那一本书呢, 快乐, 那本书秘密呢, 就是关于怎么样, 得到你所要的东西。
You want something, you can have it.
你要一样东西, 你就可以得到它。
Then you'll be happy.
那你就快乐。
Yeah, so this master's way very different.
可是这个印度导师的教法却非常的不一样。
Actually, Buddha's way also very different.
其实佛陀的方法也是很不一样。
Also, our eminent teacher's way is very different.
而且我们的金丝导师的方法也是不一样。
If you have any kind of desire, then suffering appears.
如果你有任何的欲望呢，那痛苦就跟着来了。
Only take away this desire, then already happy.
那你把这欲望、这有所求呢除去，那你就会快乐。
There's a story in the Jewish tradition.
在犹太族里面呢，有一个传统。
One time, a visitor came to see a very famous rabbi, a great scholar and a great holy man.
有一回呢，有一个访者。 来找一个犹太教士。
This visitor came from far away, but when he arrived at the rabbi's place, he only had a small bag with him.
那这访者来自远方，可是当他到了这犹太教士的地方呢，他只提着一个小袋子。
So the rabbi said, "Oh, you come from far away, but." Where's your luggage? Where's your suitcase?
教师就问他，你打从远方来，那你的行李呢，在哪里呀？
Then this man said, "Oh no, I'm just passing by."
那房子说，啊，不是的，我只是路过此地。
Then as this visitor was talking with the rabbi, he noticed this rabbi's room. Although he was very, very famous, a very great man, but there was almost nothing in the room.
那到访者呢，看到教室的房间，虽然这教室是一个非常出名的教室，可是在他的房间里面呢是空空的。Only
a simple bed, a simple desk, two chairs.
只是一个简单的床，一张简单的桌子，还有两张椅子。So
he said, "Rabbi, where's your furniture? Where are your things? Where's your carpet?"
他说：“修士啊，你的东西在哪里？你的地毯在哪里？”
Then the rabbi said, "Oh, I'm like you. I'm just passing by."
那修士说：“我像你一样，也是路过。”
So, sutra text says, "We come into this world when we're born. We arrive empty-handed." When we die, we also leave empty-handed.
当我们去的时候呢，去也是空空的，去的时候拿走空空的。
So it doesn't matter how much we gather in this life.
那在这一生中，我们无论收集了多少事物东西啊，那重要吗？
When we leave, there's not much we can take with us.
当我们离开的时候，我们能带些什么呢？
I cannot speak for all traditions, but in the Zen tradition, we've had cases of even young children attaining enlightenment.
我不可以代表一切的宗派，不过我甚至知道有些甚至在佛教里面，有些甚至儿童啊，孩子也是能够开悟的。
In Korea, there's a temple which is called a six-year-old enlightenment temple.
在韩国有一间寺庙叫做六岁开悟寺。
Because it is said that in this temple, a six-year-old boy once attained enlightenment.
因为据说呢，在这寺庙里面有一个六岁的孩童开悟了。
Then at the same time, advanced age is also no hindrance.
同时呢，可是年长者也没有什么障碍。
Yeah, Joju Zen Master attained enlightenment when he was 60 years old.
弟子禅师呢是60岁开悟的。
Then 20 more years, he deepened his experience, continued to practice, and only at the age of 80 did he start teaching.
那20年后呢，还有更深入的证悟。 那他80岁才开始教导。
Right now, I have a student in Russia who just not long ago, I was there for a 10-day retreat, and this is a 10-year-old boy.
最近呢，在苏联，我领导了一个十天的禅修，那里面呢有一个儿童，一个才有10岁的儿童。
Who participated in the entire retreat, not missing any of the activities.
他参与了禅修里面的一切活动，并没有缺席。
It was quite a rigorous retreat, and he did so very happily and with good humor.
那是一个挺艰难、挺挑战性的禅修，但是呢，他还是蛮有幽默感的。
So really, it depends on individual propensity.
其实呢是。 看个人的因素而定。
Seems that age is not really important.
年龄呢，似乎并不重要。
It's going into the right direction. Whether it will attain or not is another thing, but at least whether the way is correct.
In the Zen tradition, first of all, there is no path.
我们都在追求这个，但是在追求这个开悟，有些什么症状，我们可以知道我们到底得到了吗？
If you look at Buddhism as a whole, of course, there are many schools, many approaches.
禅师说是这是没有什么道的。如果你看到佛教里面肯定有很多不同的宗派，不同的方式。
So, for example, Tibetan Buddhism or Theravada Buddhism, there's a very definite path.
例如在藏传佛教还有南传佛教，他们有很清楚的道路。
From A, go to B, go to C, etc.
从甲到乙到丙，如以此类推。
The problem with Zen is there is no such thing.
但是在禅宗里面是没有这回事的。
So, since there is no path, it's best not to check.
既然是没有道呢，就不要去审查。
Just continue going.
Yeah. The moment you're checking, you lose your don't know.
当你审查的时候呢，你就失去了不知。Sorry,
Western mind.
对不起，这是西方的思想。Yeah.
You don't know. There's no Western.
在不知里面没有东西，没有西方。So
if you come because of desire, that's not so useful. Okay. But you have to distinguish between desire and aspiration.
如果你是为了欲望而来呢，那就不那么好。但是你得分辨欲望跟希望之间。Desire
means only for myself, okay?
欲望是为了自己本身。
So maybe somebody thinks, okay, I go to Dharma talk, then maybe I'll get something for myself.
可能感觉到说，哦，如果我听这开示呢，可能我为自己得到什么东西的。
Maybe I get the secret to be happy, to get good job.
可能我会得到
good karma,
得到快乐的秘密，得到好工作的秘密。
But aspiration has no I in it, okay?
但是在愿望里面没有我这个东西的。
That means actually it's kind of a big desire. We say bodhisattva desire.
其实是一个很大的愿望，说菩萨愿。
Means I want to understand myself.
就是说我要了解自己。
And help all beings.
然后帮助一切众生。
So there's dharma talk.So I go to Dharma talk, then maybe I can learn something that will help my practicing.
那就是有开示，可能我去开示呢，我去听开示呢，会对我的修行有帮助。
So this kind of desire, no problem. Okay.
这种望呢是没有问题的。
Because ultimately, this desire not for you.
因为最终呢，这种望，这愿望呢，不是为了你自己。
So if you have a desire, base metal and try to convert it to gold.
就是以前的术士，他们把一般的铁呢化成金。
So Zen practice is also kind of alchemy.
禅宗呢也是有点像这类的修士。
You don't reject anything, but it's possible to transmute it.
你不排除任何的东西，而且可以把它转化。
Then Your desire can become great love.
那你的愿望呢？可能转化为大慈。
Yeah. Your anger become great compassion.
那你的嗔怒呢？可能转变大悲。
And your ignorance can become great wisdom.
你的无知呢？可以转化成智慧，大智慧。
So if you're practicing, doesn't matter where you come from, what you bring with you. Just you begin.Then continue, then everything changes.
你开始修行的时候并不，你从哪里来并不重要，最重要是你开始的时候还要你继续修下去那个方向。
So whatever is your motivation at the beginning, will not necessarily be your motivation down the road.
你开始的推动力跟你接着下去的推动力并不可能，可能不一样，不一定一样。
You know, my experience is that usually people come to practice for very selfish reasons.
据我的经验呢，通常人们来修行都是为了一些自私的理由。
Most often as a result of some kind of suffering.
通常呢是为了解决一些自己的痛苦，某种痛苦。
The only very few people come for very high reason.
只有很少数部分的人。修行是为了更高的理，更崇高的理由。
High reason means maybe their life is okay, everything is no problem, but they really concern about this world and all the suffering that's in it. So they want to do something, they want to help, are looking for a way to help.
崇高的理由呢，就是说他们自己生命中一切都没问题，都无碍。可能他们是寻找一些某些方法呢，来帮助其他人、其他众生，或者帮助这个世界。
So very, very few people come to practice with that kind of motivation.
所以呢，很少人是为了这种理由和这种推动力而来的。
But doesn't matter.
但并不重要。
Because everybody, if they continue, then slowly the reason for practicing changes, all becomes as bodhisattva, bodhisattva motivation.
但是呢，当每个人慢慢的修行，慢慢的修，慢慢的修，他们的这些推动力都转化成大菩萨的推动力。